It's like a storm that cuts a path. It breaks your will. It feels like that. You think you're lost, but you're not lost on your own. You're not alone.
You know, I can't even leave the house with her. So to me, I wouldn't have even felt comfortable putting her in school. I wouldn't have felt like I could, like, we were at our wits' end with her when we didn't know what was going on. And then they would teach us simple things that, like, that's all we needed to do? Oh my gosh, you know, so they, yeah, I cannot even, words cannot say, they were so much more than just a school, it was, yeah. It was a family, to us it was our family. Yeah.
Definitely, I would say it wasn't just dropping her off and them teach her, and then we pick her up, it was, here's what we did and it worked good, or what did you do?
Maybe they taught us.
And we just, you know,
physical things to do, and then they also just the emotional support. I remember one time, Emily was having this horrible day. She went to go wash her hands, and I looked over, and Teacher Pat was sitting in one of those little tiny kid chairs, and I just ran over to her and fell on my knees and put my head on her lap and just sobbed. And she just, like a mama, just stroked my hair, you know. And those sort of things happen all the time there. They're not just there for the kids; they're there for the parents. So. They were our family.
It hurts my heart to see you cry. I know it's dark, this part of life. Oh, it finds us all.
It's hard to take at first, but then it's like we have a game plan, so just go with it. And I knew that they'd do the best for my kids, for any of the kids here. I just, like I said, full trust that they will provide everything that my kids need to help them get to make the gains they need to make. Oh yes, without question, yeah. They're always looking out for what's best for each kid, for the kids, definitely. I've seen amazing progress. My daughter, they've been here for a year and a half, and my daughter is probably going to test out of services already. And then my son has gone from speaking, almost not speaking at all, to talking in sentences, trying to read things, interacting with kids, interacting with adults, trying to play. Just an incredible increase in what he's been able to do. My daughter probably would not have been ready for kindergarten. If she hadn't been here.
Be afraid to fall. I'm right here to catch you. I won't let you down. He won't get you down. You're gonna make it. Yeah, I know you can make it.
I think our greatest fear after finding out the diagnosis was the fear of the unknown, you know. There's so many things that went through our minds, and we really couldn't put our finger on what the greatest fear was. I think it was just a combination of everything. The fear of the unknown was just weighed heavily upon us. But we made it. We're here. And, you know, there's concern, but I don't think there's any more fear.
No, things would be different. And I know as a family, we worked hard to support him and help him, but we're limited in our knowledge of how to help him learn best. So I know that he wouldn't be as far along in his reading, he wouldn't be as far along in his writing and his understanding. Comprehension would not be what it is. As much as parents can read and educate themselves, we need the support of people who have the education that know how to educate those with special challenges. We wouldn't be where we are today if it weren't for the teachers that have come along beside us and supported us.
I will stand by you. I will help you through when you've done all you can do and you can't. won't let you go.